Welcome to my classes. Today we will be understanding the concept of standard cell. So first we will see what is standard cell and what are the conditions for a cell to be standard, and then we will move on to one of the standard cell, that is Western standard cell. Okay, so here I have written three conditions. So if I need to tell my cell to be standard, then they should satisfy all these three conditions. What are those? First is EMF of the cell is reproducible and constant. Means whatever the EMF of the cell will be there, that should be always constant. It should not vary or it should not change. This is the first criteria. Okay. And then the cell should be reversible. You already know what is reversible, isn't it? So here what the cell should be reversible. That is, we can utilize that. Okay. And then next, it should have low temperature coefficient of EMF. This is very, very important. What is it saying that? Low temperature coefficient of EMF means, if I vary the temperature, remember, if I vary the temperature, then my EMF should not vary. Or even though if it is changing or if it is varying, that EMF change with respect to temperature should be very negligible or it should be very less. Okay. So if the cell is satisfying all these three conditions, then it is said to be a standard cell. Okay. So now, the cell which satisfies all these three conditions is which cell? That is Western standard cell. Okay. That is called as Western standard cell. This is a cell which is satisfying all these three conditions, and it is mostly used as a standard cell. So now let us in detail understand how the Western standard cell is constructed. Okay, let's go through. So here you can see, this is the Western standard cell. Okay, so here the cell is satisfying what? The conditions of standard cell. Okay, so here the cell, this Western standard cell EMF will not vary much with that of the temperature, and it is reversible, and its EMF is reproducible and constant. Okay. So we have taken this as a standard cell. Okay. Now the thing is, here you can see it is in the form of what? H shape. Okay, it is looking like in the shape of H. And here you can see that here one limb is consisting of mercury. Okay, here this is one limb and another one limb. Okay, here this one limb is consisting of mercury, which is serving as what? Positive electrode. Okay, so it is taken as a positive. Okay, and then another, and it is also covered with what here? H2SO4 paste. Okay, that is mercurous sulfate. It is covered with mercurous sulfate. And on the other side, you can see that cadmium amalgam is taken. So if mercury is taken, then you will tell it as amalgam. Okay, so here you can see that cadmium amalgam, that is 12.5% of that is taken in another limb, and which is serving as a negative electrode. Clear? And here you can see that cadmium, hydrated cadmium sulfate is there. Okay, which is split above this cadmium amalgam. So here you can see that Hg. So it is in the Hg2SO4 paste, and here you can see that cadmium amalgam, that is CdHg, is in cadmium sulfate, which has been hydrated. Okay, and here you can see again both limbs are covered with what? Saturated cadmium sulfate solution. Clear? And here you can see that these both are connected by the platinum wires. Okay, for the connection purpose, they act as an inert electrode. Okay, so this is all about what? The construction of this Western standard cell. Okay, now we will see the cathodic and anodic reactions. Clear? So here you can see that the cadmium reduction potential is very less. Hence, what happens at anodic reaction? Your oxidation takes place. Cadmium, it will lose two of its electron and it forms Cd+2. And here you can see cathodic reaction, this whatever mercurous mercurous sulfate is there, no? That will take two electrons and then it will undergo the reduction. So at anode, oxidation takes place and at cathode, reduction takes place. So overall reaction will be definitely your cadmium is solid plus Hg2SO4 is in equilibrium with Cd2 plus SO4 2 minus and 2Hg. Okay, that will be the overall reaction. Okay, so here near cadmium, what happens? Your oxidation takes place and it acts as an anode. Okay, and your cathode is nothing but your mercury, okay, mercurous sulfate, that will act as a cathode and reduction takes place there. So one thing what you can remember in this cell is, so the EMF is constant. So what is the EMF of this cell? So the EMF of the cell is 1.108. okay, EMF of the cell is how much? 1.108. okay, so and this, whatever this EMF is there, no, this is at what? At particular temperature, that is 20 degrees Celsius. This EMF is observed at 20 degree Celsius. So whatever this EMF is there, it will not change or it will not much vary with that of the temperature. Hence, this cell is taken as a standard cell. Okay. So this is all about the explanation of standard cell, cathodic anodic reaction, overall reaction, and EMF of the cell. I hope you understood the Weston standard cell. Thank you.